Quote, a senior advisor to Hillary Clinton's 2008 presidential campaign, who was accused of repeatedly sexually harassing a young subordinate, was kept on the campaign at Mrs. Clinton's request, according to four people familiar with what took place. Wait, you mean that a woman who is so brave, so stunning, who's broken every glass ceiling except the last one left, that woman left a guy on her campaign who was sexually harassing the help? She would never do anything like that. She would never stay married to such a person. She would never defend such a person and threaten his accuser. She would never do something like that. She is a feminist icon. And then you wonder why we don't take the Democrats seriously. You wonder why we don't take the Grammys seriously. You wonder why we don't take their politics seriously, reading from this fire and fury nonsense. And Mrs. Clinton's campaign manager at the time recommended she fire the advisor, Burns Strider, which is a hell of a name. Mrs. Clinton did not. Instead, Mr. Strider was docked several weeks of pay in order to undergo counseling, and the young woman was moved to a new job. Just like a man to do this. Just like a man, except she's a woman. Mr. Strider, who's Mrs. Clinton's faith advisor. Ah, so great. So her faith advisor was sexually harassing the help. She kept him on so he could advise her about faith. Yes, I wonder why the American public did not take Hillary Clinton more seriously. And I wonder why the Hillary Clinton feminist icon shtick just didn't work. I can't imagine why. He sent the candidate scripture readings every morning for months during that campaign. He was hired 5 years later to lead an independent group that supported Mrs. Clinton's 2016 candidacy, Correct the Record, which was created by David Brock. Nothing says faith advisor, by the way, like working with David Brock, one of the scuzziest people in the history of mankind. He was fired after several months for workplace issues, including allegations he harassed a young female aide, according to three people close to the Correct the Record management. Hillary Clinton had no statement on this. A spokesman for Mrs. Clinton provided a statement, said to ensure a safe working environment, the campaign had a process to address complaints of misconduct or harassment. When matters arose, they were reviewed in accordance with these policies and appropriate action was taken. This complaint was no exception. Yeah, except for how the guy remained on the campaign and the woman was apparently banished off to anti-feminist land. But don't worry, Hillary got straight from fire and fury at the Grammys because she'll never go.